your fingers are almost hyperextending backwards. So trying to grab the water, you're going to lose some of that. You want to, generally, I think they say a 10 degree, you know, a little bit of space between the fingers, not this cramped. And then, you know, if you could point them kind of in, like a little bit of a skull. But you get some wicked hyperextension on those things. And you can see right there, probably losing some power in that initial. You have a little bit more bubbles you're carrying with you than what Caleb had. Some people argue that you want to have a cleaner entry, fewer bubbles on that. Other people don't think it really matters. I would be in the category of I'm not sure that it matters. But one thing that you're not doing is see how when your hands enter, they just kind of stab straight trying to get into it. I do think that little, you know, lift of the fingers to grab out front does help. And it's just something to play with in practice. And that's what you can do with this technology. You can actually go through, let's say, just play the rest of your stuff. That's Caleb, sorry. One of the things you can do, you know, if you change something in your stroke, a lot of times to see if it's working, what you have to do, you do 25s or 50s, and you have to hold the exact same pace, and you have to have somebody that's waiting at the wall for you at the exact time so you can compare, did that improve, did I go faster, did I go slower, and it's hard to keep the pace all the time. It's hard for somebody to just sit and watch over you, you know, they're watching a bunch of other people at the same time. With this, what you can do is you can actually get distance. If we look at a couple of stroke cycles, we just pick, you know, or even a certain amount of time. Let's say we just go, we'll go 3 second interval. What you can do in this program, you can integrate that line. You guys taken calculus yet? Integrals. So the integral measures, so this is measuring distance divided by time. And what you can do is you can look at this graph and say, okay, what about this value under that line? And that would give you distance. So here we're looking at just a 3 second frame, but it tells you the distance covered in that 3 seconds was 4.875 meters. So the nice thing you can do, you don't have to swim a full lap, you get, you know, 4 or 5 good stroke cycles in it, and then you can integrate that area, and let's say you change something else.
Wait, so what you're saying is we didn't even look at the rules.
Oh yeah. That too. Yeah, if you could fit it on this. Good luck finding the equation of that one. Yeah, I don't know. But the nice thing is, so you don't even have to video it, it's just something you can do really quick. You can, you know, just say, all right, I'm gonna do my normal stroke, and then get a recording for that, come back, okay, I'm gonna change something. I'm gonna put my fingers closer together, further apart, or I'm gonna do a harder kick or something. And you can compare it. You can do either a couple of stroke cycles, or you can do, like I said, just a short time interval, 3 seconds, and compare how much distance was covered in that. And if you're changing, if you have a shorter distance, like, yeah, well, that's not really working. And again, the nice thing about it, you're looking at really small increments, things that are gonna get missed when you do 25 repeats or 50 repeats all the time. Because when somebody's doing a stopwatch, you know, it has to stop exactly. It has to start exactly, you know, when you leave, and that's not gonna happen. So by looking at this, you're able to take, you know, just a few tenths of a second in that period, just a short distance. And if you can improve that, think about what happens in a 100-yard race, right? You can just almost straight multiply that out.